first single, Please Don't Go Girl. And since we've been touring, just traveling all the time and being so busy, sometimes the only time you have to yourself is on the bus, just looking out the window and watching the world go by.
The honest truth, in my opinion, about how we came together is that it was destiny.
Look at this crowd, it's real dope, bro.
I'm looking for a J, man.
Yo!
What up?
Let's get a new sign going, yo! Word. New kids!
The new kids on the block are just five guys who really care about people.
Yo, I'm lost, guys, it's a maze!
Some of the guys in the group grew up together, and, you know, we never dreamed about, you know, becoming famous or anything, becoming singers. You know, we had rough lives growing up, so we couldn't sit there every day thinking about, oh, man, I want to be a star, because we were too busy thinking about, you know, how am I going to get through tomorrow?
The shark bites with his teeth, the deer, come on, and he shows them. No, but seriously, Frank Sinatra did perform here. Frank Sinatra's one of my favorite guys, the golden nugget right here. You heard it live from New Kids Television.
You bad?
The bus could never be home, but it's the closest thing to home for us. When we're on the bus, it's either me and Joe playing Nintendo, or Jordan playing his keyboard and everyone singing along or goofing around, or everyone just going to sleep and relaxing and just getting away from all the madness.
Oh, I'm tired.
How's it going, Uncle Rob?
Everything is cool. Kick the house down in 5-10 minutes.
Uh-oh. Hey, John, you got some flowers. What's that?
I feel shunned. None from me.
John, they know who the real star is here, Jim. Uh-oh. They know who the real star is. Roses, too? Not that.
Joe? Hold on. I'm getting shunned. Oh, Joe.
Joey,
my
baby.
I give up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
I quit. No one loves me.
I love you, Joey.
Oh, thank you.
What's that, eggs?
No, it's stuffed sole. It has a hollandaise sauce on it.
Sole?
Uh-huh, fish.
That's, and, looks
yeah.
like eggs.
Take my word, it's not eggs. Honest.
What's this, chicken?
This dinner is a very common dinner we have on the road, which is fried chicken.
How slop?
We've had it for about 8 cities in a row now, and every time we get to a new city, the people tell us we're going to have something different to eat. But it's been the same since about a week or two. Just go with it.
Now this, I'm not too sure about, but I'm going to try it anyway. My mother got me into the habit of just try it, you might like it. So I will try.
Today's extra special day because I have rice and chicken, which are two of my favorite foods. Of course, we always drink milk with our meals. We don't drink soda, we drink milk, vitamin D.
Anybody got no last thing?
Oh, Joe!
The sound
hey,
man.
Joe the sound man!
Let's go see if they're trying to change hands. Come on, finally. Hey, wait a minute. No, this is for children's viewing. They can't see this.
Most important thing to you about becoming famous?
Being in the situation, you can move people. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And peer pressure now is always to do negative things, you know. And as you can see in the streets and stuff, kids always want to top each other. Some kids, if they drink, you know, the next group of kids is going to want to top them, and they'll get into something harder, like smoking marijuana or something, and then the next kids will top them. So we want to show that, we want to, you know, set positive things in motion, like, you know, doing good things and have kids top the good things with other good things instead of with bad things.
Mm-hmm. What makes you the most nervous?
Girls that I like make me nervous.
Really?
Like, that I really True. Like, you know, and I'm attracted to, I get nervous.
I get nervous with girls, too.
That's
girls I like, I get real nervous.
What about the girlfriend question?
How do you answer?
What do you answer to that?
Girls. Single and
no
very
girlfriend.
It's funny, though. Sometimes the girls are so choked up, they don't say anything. Mm-hmm. You know what? Like, when we go home, there's a place we used to hang out called DYC, and every time we go there, no matter when we go home, if we haven't been home for 2 months, if we go there, there's a group of girls outside waiting for us. And one day, me and Jordan pulled up there, and we got out of the car, and we walked up, and they were standing there. They must have been waiting there all day for us, and when we walked by them, they all went, oh, my God, they turned away from us.
Yeah.
They never said anything.
Right. I was shopping downtown Boston one day, and this girl saw me and then started following me, and everywhere I went, she was right behind me. And I would, and Donnie was with me too, but he had a hat and glasses on, so he was acting as my bodyguard. Right? And she kept following me wherever I went. And Donnie kept saying, can you leave him alone, please, miss? And she kept saying, well, I just want to get to know him.
I was imitating my bodyguards by doing that. I wasn't being me.
She said the same thing to me. She said, I'm not following because of who you are, dude. You better not think that. Because if you think that, you'll be stuck up. And I would, but... of course she was following me because she knew I was the new kids on the block.
Back inside.
You try growing some facial hair first. Did you get it yet?
Not that one hand?
Yeah.
Cover
people?
Soon.
Okay. Hangin' Tough is just about strength. If you listen to the lyrics of the song, it's about just being yourself and doing your own thing and not letting anybody tell you that you can't do this or you have to do this or that. And Hangin' Tough, in my eyes, symbolizes that no matter what the challenge is or no matter how great it is, we're gonna conquer it. The huddle is just that one moment of unity before we go on, when we let each other know, hey, you know, the fight we had earlier is over, or, you know, the disagreement we had earlier is over, or, hey, guys, you know, we're all in this together. Let's go out there and kick some butt. We didn't come here just to make our fast million and take off, you know. We came here to do a job, and that's to be good role models for every kid in the country and in the world. We're trying to reach out to every kid and say, hey, you know, you can do the right thing. It's not about, you know, being cool, because being cool is being yourself. And that's what the New Kids on the Block want to get across to every kid out there.